Hello friends, Satyendra here, and in today's video we'll see how to use spacebar to repeat the last command in SOLIDWORKS, just like AutoCAD. And if you are familiar with AutoCAD, we use spacebar frequently to activate the previous command in AutoCAD. For example, I have AutoCAD open here and I will use different commands to create the entities. Like to create a circle, I will go to circle command and I will create the circle. If I want to recreate a circle, I'll just press spacebar and I will recreate the circle. In the same way, if I want to create rectangle, I'll go for the command, I will create the rectangle. If I need, once again I'll just press the spacebar and create the rectangle. Line command, I will go for line, I will draw a line, and if I need one more line, I will just press spacebar to activate the command and I will create the line. This makes our work easier and faster, and it avoids unnecessary mouse movement and command selection. So in that way also it reduces our effort and saves our time. So the same thing we can do in SOLIDWORKS. We can use same spacebar to activate previous command and we can save lot of time. And now we'll see how to do this in SOLIDWORKS. So for that, we'll go to SOLIDWORKS. So this is my SOLIDWORKS. I have one part open here. Now if you use any command here, and if you want to reuse the same command, you need to move your mouse to select the command. If the same thing you are doing again and again, it consumes a lot of time. But if you use spacebar, in a fraction of a second, you can reactivate the same command and you can save a lot of time. And this will help you not only in part, it will help you in sheet metal, drawing, sketch, assembly, wherever you want. For example, if I'm creating extrude cut here onto this face, say normal, I need to have one pitch circle here. So I will go for circle. I'll create a circle here. I will come out from the command and I will convert this circle to construction geometry for pitch circle. Now I need to have four circle here to create extrude cut. So no need to go to the circle command once again. If you press the space bar, your circle command will be reactivated and you can create your circle here. But now if I press the space bar, it gives me orientation. So first I will set space bar to repeat the same command or the previous command, and then we'll try this practice. I'll just discard this and come out from the sketch. Delete this sketch, and now first we'll set the space bar to repeat the same command again, and then we'll try the same practice again. So for that, first you need to go to customize and here go to keyboard, and in this area you have search for. You try to search repeat here. And you will see that repeat last command is here. Click here and press your spacebar. Say yes. Say okay. That's it. Now your spacebar is set for the previous command. And now I'll try the same practice. I will go to extrude cut. I'll select this face, say normal. And here I will draw the pitch circle. In case I am out from the command, again no need to go to the circle. Here only I'll just press space bar and my circle command will be active, because circle command was the previous command. I can draw my circle. In case you are not out of the command, you can reuse the same thing. But if you are out from this, again press the space bar and you can get the previous command. So this way it will be very helpful. Now I'll just select this four circles and make it equal, and I will assign dimension for this 6.5 and this 1.5. This one I will just convert to construction geometry and say okay, done. Let us see one more example. Suppose I need to create a flange here. I'll go for edge flange. I'll select this edge. I'll drag it up. And due to some reason, I came out from this command. So again, no need to move your cursor and select this command. Here only I will press spacebar and my command will be active. I can create here. I can create here. If again I'm out of the command, once again I'll just press the spacebar. My command is active. I can create here, 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 and here. So this way, this is very helpful, and this is not only helpful in the part, it is helpful in sketch, sheet metal, assembly, wherever you want. So if you use this spacebar, you can save your lot of time and you can do your work faster. So this is it, guys. Now like this video if the video is helpful, share this video with your friends and subscribe my channel for further updates.